comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane.
Clay, thank you so much for speaking with me. And, you know, it's kind of funny because as we speak, I was actually thinking to myself, last weekend, probably, and I think would have been the Santa Claus parade that we are so used to being part of, which is, of course, a Toronto tradition, being out there downtown, watching all the great floats and the performers, and, of course, the jolly old elf himself. But things are completely different, and seeing the Santa Claus parade this year is going to be completely different. Chris, thank you for making sure that this was happening. How is this going to happen, and how can we still be part of this great tradition?
Yeah, thank you, Rudy. Appreciate that. We're excited, and you're right. This year has, like for so many events and traditions, caused things to change. And we're really thankful that our partners have stuck with us, and we have a great partnership with CTV so that we're able to bring a really unique made-for-television version of the parade to life. It's going to air nationwide on Saturday, December the 5th at 7 p.m., and it's a parade unlike any other, unlike any we've done before, I should say. So that it's going to be, for the first time, filmed at night against the backdrop of beautiful Canada's Wonderland. Really an amazing, amazing backdrop for the parade and for the floats and for some traditions that get to live on. We're still going to see marching bands in position playing. There's going to be wonderful hosts and musical guests. And musical performances. So we're really excited. The parade will look a little bit different, but we think that Canadians are still in for a great show.
So let's make sure we have this straight. This isn't going to be any like past films or footage or anything like that. This is actually going to be a parade. We're just seeing it in a different type of format.
That's right. We still have a host of new floats as well as some returning favorites. We have marching bands that were filmed under safe under all the current COVID guidelines, and then as well other performances filmed in other locations remotely, the floats are still, our team is still working hard despite a shutdown that everyone in Ontario experienced, to build a host of new floats that Canadians are going to get to see on the broadcast.
So there's a lot of bonuses to this because, number one, of course, everybody is going to be safe. The other thing, too, for folks who have been to Canada's Wonderland, especially when Canada's Wonderland has done their holiday season presentation, having these floats and this parade there with Canada's Wonderland backdrop is going to look absolutely Christmas amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. It's I you know, we hesitate. We don't want to give away too much because we really think that the viewers are in for a treat. It's really is going to be a beautiful backdrop with lights and just I don't want to give it away, Rudy. It's
going
to be a great environment for people to see the floats and to really feel that Christmas spirit, feel the holiday magic. And see all of our floats and Santa and Mrs. Claus and Mother Goose, all of them in a new way. So it's really exciting.
The other bonus is the fact that folks are going to be able to watch it at home, and they, you know, some people already got their Christmas trees up, so they can actually have their home set up for the Christmas season. They can have their eggnog, they can have their hot chocolate, they can have, you know, put on their Christmas sweaters, ugly Christmas sweaters, sit around, maybe if they have a fireplace, have that going, and watch it. This is going to be an amazing experience. The more I keep thinking about this.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we touched on it earlier on the call. You touched on it, that the parade is tradition, and families see it as that for, you know, for generations. Families have seen it as the start of the holiday season, whether it's you know, going out down to the streets of Toronto and seeing it or watching it on television and then putting up the tree, as you alluded to. And those traditions can continue, which we're just really thankful for. We saw it as a responsibility. We're thankful to the partners who have that have supported us. We're thankful to the folks at CTV for putting together what we think is going to be a fantastic program so that this very, very important tradition can continue, and provide families, you know, perhaps just a little bit of a little bit of an escape for a couple of hours on Saturday in December so that they can think about all the good that comes with the holiday season and spend some time, create some new traditions while watching the parade in a new way.
Okay, so can you mention a few of the floats, some of the new ones, and some of the traditional ones?
Yeah, so of course, Mother Goose is back this year, leading off the parade, sponsored by Manulife. So Mother Goose has been leading off the floats for decades. The celebrity clowns are back in a limited capacity, as well as a celebrity clowning around at home program that we have launched this year. There are some new floats, courtesy of Canadian Tire, and as well, Scotiabank has supported a frontline workers. Heroes float. So giving thanks to all of the frontline workers who have supported us throughout this pandemic, whether they be nurses and doctors or delivery people or grocery store workers. So really excited for people to see those floats and all of them, as you mentioned, in the new decor. It's going to make all the floats really stand out and pop.
Two things as we wrap this up. Number one, we're used to doing the traditional Red Noses. It's a great charity. Is there any way that we can still give back to some of these charities that the Santa Claus Parade is part of? And also, I guess there's going to have to be a different way for kids who are used to bringing their letters to Santa to the parade. They'll probably have to do it a different way this year, just to remind them.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, obviously, the great folks from Canada Post, just to touch on that last point, the great folks from Canada Post will be receiving Santa letters at mailboxes across the country, so kids can certainly get their letters to Santa off that way. We've partnered this year with Ultima Dental, and at all of their GTA locations, you can purchase a red nose and support the Santa Claus Parade. In addition, this year, we're really excited that on December the 1st, we'll be launching the Santa Claus Parade Countdown to Christmas 50-50 raffle. So participants and purchasers from Ontario, residents of Ontario, are able to purchase online 50-50 raffle tickets that will be in support of the MLSC Foundation, the CP24 Chum Christmas Wish, as well as the Santa Claus Parade, with proceeds supporting those charities and the parade. So another way for Canadians to get engaged, and they'll be able to purchase tickets at 5050santa.com beginning December 1st all the way up until December 19th.
There we go. Old traditions and new traditions are now together. Absolutely love this. So one more time, when do we get to see this great Christmas experience once again, and also website for more information on all the fun things that are going to be happening?
Yeah, absolutely. We want to make sure that Canadians are tuned in and enjoy the show on CTV on Saturday, December the 5th at 7 p.m. And for all the details related to all the activities related to the Santa Claus Parade, as well as information on the broadcast, visit us at thesantaclausparade.com.
Thank you so much once again, and Merry Christmas.
You too, Rudy. Thank you.
Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, 'cause Santa Claus comes tonight.